Well, hello, we are together, we're going to make a mission run, if we can. If we can. I did something with my laptop here, okay. The FPS improved. This is still the same build as yesterday, the build AH. I can't remember the numbers, man. I'm so sorry, it's 67158 or something like this. But I know it's build AH. At the beginning, I was between 2 and 7 frames. No matter what I do, I was disconnecting, reconnecting, rebooting my computer, redoing it, etc, 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 right? However, in the meantime, I looked into the DX-DIAG, right? The diagnostic from DirectX. And something was very strange, because I would not choose a laptop with a CPU that runs only at 2.5 GHz, right? And on top of my head, I was like, that's impossible. It must have a turbo boost of 3 gigs at least, you know. And you know, my CPU is a 4-core as well. It's a 4710MQ. And so I was like, dude, that's so strange. So I downloaded CPU IC, and what it tell me is that effectively it's a 2.5, but it does have a turbo boost that goes up to 3.5 gigahertz. And I was like, dude, that's impossible now. And that makes my CPU very average with the grand or vast majority of gamers, right? In the PTU right now, so I don't understand why my FPS will be between 2 and 7 FPS only at all time. So what I did is that I checked my performances, and my performances in Windows 10, I don't have a choice. It only says balance, that's it. I don't know if you can see it, but I press F. And there you go, finally. No, it disappeared again. I keep on F, I'm not touching any other key, if you see it on the keyboard. There you go. So yeah, I had only one, you know, that comes standard with the laptop. It's called balance. So I checked in the balance, and my CPU says if my CPU is idle, I use only 5% of power. So I said to myself, you know what, that might be a tick. That might be a kick here. Meaning, oh shit, if there is still a problem with the game itself, you know, in the code, that just interprets. Okay, let's be on that. Let's see. No, I'm not wrong. There may be a problem in the code that interprets a game is not a game, and therefore doesn't need any more power than that. So I'm not saying I was at 5% of our power capacity. My point is that I might have been at all time set up at using 2.5 GHz. That's it. Never a turbo boost. Ever since, I created another profile from the standard Windows 10 balanced. That's the only choice I have. I created my own where I, no matter what, I use this 100% of CPU, no matter what. It can be idle, it can be underload or whatever. Always 100%. And it's not perfect. But I do see now, I do see my my FPS climbing up a little bit. You know, sometimes I see it down by 5, 6, 7 FPS, and sometimes I just see it goes like 10, 12, 13. In that build AH, before the build AH, I had much better performances between, like right now, between something like 11 and 16 FPS, right? And on occasion, I even had much better FPS, up to 50, 60, and even one time up to 120 FPS. I know I was not alone, because I've heard other people talking in the text chat, right? However, I have no idea how many people we were. Maybe it was just the beginning of a new server, who knows? It's just, it makes me know that it doesn't come from my head. So, the only thing I can tell right now is perhaps to be something to investigate if Star Citizen at a code level does engage its CPU as a video game, therefore would kick the correct video driver, because I have two driver. I have the Nvidia and I have the fucking Intel, right, which I never use. That for a fact it is, no matter what, it's set on default to use the Nvidia 960M. However, for the CPU side, I just realized a moment ago that I was just on balanced performance, so that might have something to do, that even if it's unbalanced, no matter what, at a code level, Star Citizen should keep the processor in. Might the processor alone help me boost my FPS a little bit? I have no idea. Because unfortunately, I don't have anything on screen that tells me anything else. So, the only thing I can do is perhaps minimize Star Citizen and check into the CPU IC. But that's all I can do. And the heat just went as if I was with the BT as well. Like right now again. I pressed N to go combat mode and the heat just twisted. It doesn't happen very often, to be honest. This is the first time I see it do that. So we said we were on a mission, right? It is unspecified. Let's go do it. Hey, look at that. Right in front of us, 800 something. Which means it's Delamar. Am I right? Oh my gosh, I didn't see that, but look at my screen. I have radar and that screen on. Let me do this right after the jump, okay? So all the screens are off, right? Again. This time let's do it one by one. Yep, no. One by one. Do you see that? That twist again. So yes, that's another bug again. I did not try the class in it with AH. This is my very first time. So many trouble anyway that yeah, I just skipped it. I should have tried. You know what, guys? If I can succeed in finishing that mission, which means getting paid and everything, right? If I succeed in that mission, that means that will be the first time I can run a cargo mission of sorts since I entered the PTO. Since the very first build that was given to Wave 2, second wave. And it's not for to try, so it's not for to try at all. Because boy, I try. I would be so excited if I can just do one. Just to have the feeling of it. One time I almost succeeded, except I didn't know where to place the fucking box. I was right on the dot, right on the dot, 1 meter away, you know, or even less perhaps. But it would not dead and it would not pay me. Do you notice also I don't have the, I'm missing the square, the bracket, the square for the nose, the ship nose actual direction. That in all drills it was missing. And I believe that's what conflicts me with EVA. It's literally almost impossible and so mind-boggling sometimes, especially when you carry a crate, that if I had never played Star Citizen in 2.5, 2.6 and so on in EVA, I would be like, I would be totally lost. Totally lost. Spike, spike, spike. That was a nice spike here too. Okay, who is going to annoy the crap out of me now? Oh, they're fighting. Not anymore. Okay. See here, not readable. I don't even know why I have my weapon at hand, but if somebody comes and tries to shoot me, he will kill me. That's how good my FPS is. Oh my god. You see my EVA already going wonkers. I did not touch anything yet. Oh my gosh, I did it. Oops, that's my ship right there. I thought I had to go through a debris or something. Yeah. And that's nothing. That's nothing at all. Sometimes it's so hard. Sometimes it's so much. If I wait here for quite some time, it's going to get worse. But it's so hard that I have to get my camera as much as I can, press again Z to lock it, and then I have to control how my character goes from this view, because in first view it's just, it's impossible. And I should be okay. I think there is nothing inside. Oh, it's a zombie. Okay. Sorry for that. I lost it. So... I had to walk forward or backward to make the box cross my point of view, and I sometimes just click on it. So we have a package, right? Now what am I supposed to do with that? Oh, Shabin Outpost. That's where I went last time. I almost finished with that mission. Okay. Let's go to Shabin Outpost on demo. Because I kind of know where it is. Kind of. Because I am not sitting in my chair. Could be. I know it's above. I just want to make sure there is not another one called Shervin somewhere else. Now, 500. I don't want to crash. I don't want to crash him. There we go. So yeah, it's going to put me further away, but in much straighter path, I believe. There we go. I believe now Shervin is right in front of me. Great. Spike. Spike or disconnected, and again, oh, it was a spike. Okay, I really hope I don't get disconnected, guys. Spike, freeze, 0.1 frame per second. That was definitely a CPU spike. am in that mode. 16,000. I need to overshoot it a little bit. I was about to crash land. Remember if I need to. Okay, but there's nobody right. Beautiful! Wow. You guys really busted your ass off. Okay, why do I have that? Why do I have... crowns that when I clearly contacted Shubin, I think. There was no Shubin, it was just a distance. Okay. great. I don't even have it. Where's my ship? Did it really go away? Yeah, look at that. I went through my ship, I don't know where my ship is. I don't have any no crate whatsoever. And I think F1 doesn't work. Home doesn't work, which means I'm pressing home brought my green arrow. Alt. Left arrow doesn't work, alt, question mark doesn't work. Okay. LJ doesn't work either. So, be home, okay, pressing home, nope. That's it guys, I am on a blocker right now. I have a green arrow in front of me. And movie glass is not open. I have a green arrow, but I cannot do anything. F1 and home would not work. I don't have the crate, and I wanted to check the if I still have the mission, which I believe was withdrawn, but I'm not entirely sure. I was on the shipping mission to bring cargo bags, you know, from a caterpillar of sorts near Delamar to Delamar. Alright, thank you very much again. I'm very sorry, it's a no-go. No cargo mission again for today. Thank you.